Hey, this is Dr. Dan Jummy, and in this Sock Doc video, I want to talk about estrogen in men. Not women this time, who will hopefully have more estrogen than they do testosterone, but actually for us guys, who unfortunately, many are converting testosterone into estrogen or increasing their estrogen levels for certain reasons I want to talk about. So guys, if you're developing fat where you don't want it to be, around your waistline or extra breast tissue, around your hips, a lot of times this estrogen is going to accumulate fat around these areas, and then as in turn, sort of a double-edged sword here, that those fatty areas then increase more estrogen. A lot of estrogen is made in this fat tissue, and then the fat tissue gives you more estrogen, and the estrogen makes you more fat, and around you go. The fatter you get, the more estrogen you end up making. The number one reason today for estrogen accumulating in your body through hormone synthesis, actually, is via insulin resistance. A lot of talk about this on the Sock Doc site. When you're eating too many refined carbohydrates, your body is resistant to insulin, is no longer sensitive to insulin. Then what happens is we have a conversion enzyme called the aromatase enzyme that converts our testosterone to estrogen. And this aromatase enzyme is increased when we're eating too many carbohydrates and we become insulin resistant. So rather than hang on to our testosterone, it's converted into estrogen. It's stored in our fat tissue, and then that fat tissue makes more and more estrogen. It's a really bad thing. So the number one way to correct that, obviously, is to correct your insulin resistance. Think about eating a paleo diet. Think about eating a more high-fat diet, high-quality proteins, and get rid of the refined carbohydrates, even the fruit juices and the dried fruit. Limit the fruit. Eat a lot of vegetables. Eat a lot of healthy fats. Eat a lot of high-quality protein, and really get rid of the carbohydrates. For some people need to get rid of the carbohydrates entirely for a while, even the fruits, to deal with their insulin resistance. Different for everybody. Think about something like the two-week test. I talk about that on the Sock Doc site, as well as my Dr. Ganjemi site too. Now, from the environment, we have xenoestrogens. These are estrogen mimickers, hormone disruptors. You might have heard of this, like in plastics, like things made with BPA, bisphenol A, as well as phthalates. So these hormone disruptors can actually be in the foods that we're eating from cooking with plastics or things that are made and then wrapped and packaged in plastics, or of course cooking in your microwave too and using plastic containers, especially something like Saran wrap. There's lots of estrogen mimickers out there in the environment, and even with foods sprayed with certain pesticides. So now we consume these, and it's actually tricking our body to think that these are estrogen-like compounds, and it's influencing estrogen synthesis within our body. We're actually accumulating these xenoestrogens that way. A really good way to burn fat to help get rid of that extra estrogen too, where this estrogen is stored, is aerobic exercise. Head over to the Sock Doc site, learn how to train aerobically. Strength training is a great thing too to develop more muscle and burn fat, and start dealing with ridding your body of excess estrogen and increasing your testosterone levels again, and to block this aromatase enzyme and lower its level so you can get back into health and back into fitness too. So one last comment: soy. Stay away from soy milk and the unfermented soy products. Typically, a little bit of fermented soy is okay, like miso and tempeh and soy sauce, but ideally get rid of all the soy in your diet. Soy milk is one of the worst things you can be eating. Even tofu and all those fake meat products out there is a great way to increase estrogen mimickers in your body, estrogen-like compounds. So no soy in your diet at all. That goes the same for women too. Really stay away from soy. It's not a good thing in these great amounts that we're eating today. Hope you enjoyed the video. Lots of other information on the Sock Doc site, of course. Fitness and training, injury treatment and prevention, all 100% natural. Lots of other health topics, shoe reviews, lots of new videos coming out. Hope you enjoyed this one. Put a comment at the bottom here if you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.